श्री गौरी करुणाल हरी तो यजाक्षी शंकरीश्वरी कायौ श्री गौरी करुणाल हरी तो यजाक्षी शंकरीश्वरी।
See, as children, we realize that our father was someone very important. You know, when you're growing up, although he was a father just like any other father, but then you start realizing that your father is a very important person. Sometimes you feel you missed out, like perhaps walk in the road or something like that. But otherwise, we had a very grounded upbringing, I should say, which I'm very thankful for, especially my mother. She didn't actually advocate a lot of bad behavior. We had to talk nicely to people, including our teachers, or even to the staff, or to anyone. We
couldn't be rude to anyone. Yeah. Really. She was very particular.
And orthodox also at the same time, because both my parents were religious minded. But not that they let it interfere in their daily, you know, their routine lives. But they were religious. Conscious tutelage illa. ಹಿಂಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕು ಹಂಗೆ ಇರಬೇಕು ಅಂತಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ನಾನು ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಮೈ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇ ಡಿಂಟ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ ದೇರ್ ವ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆನ್ ಅಸ್. ವಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸಾ ದೆಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್. ದೇ ಮೇಡ್ ನೋ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. ನೀವು ಹೆಣ್ಮಕ್ಳು ನೀವು ಹಿಂಗಿರಬೇಕು, ಮೈ ಬ್ರದರ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಬಾಯ್, ಇಲ್ಲ ಅವ್ನ ಗಂಡ ಮಗ ಅವ್ನು ಹಂಗೆ, ಆ ಥರ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವತ್ತೂ ಇಲ್ಲ. ವಿ ನೆವರ್ ಗ್ರೋ ಅಪ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್. ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಮೈ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಕನ್ಸಿಡರಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ವೆರ್ ಸಚ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್. He was a very humorous person, so we spent a lot of humorous time with him, joking, laughing, like any family. Routine is like the breakfast, she said, we used to have with him. Then afterwards, he used to get busy. He got a lot of guests who came and met him, visitors and things like that, right up to lunchtime. Then lunchtime, he used to have with his mother. He used to go to Chamandivia to have his lunch. And then evening tea, he would come to my mother's place for tea and all that. And then dinner we all used to have together. Yeah. He was very fond of listening to music himself. He had, for those days, very sophisticated equipment to hear Western classical music, which we also used to hear with wonderful speakers and all that. And he had, you know, those days there was a gramophone. He loved reading. He had a wonderful library, which we also had privy to, with lovely books. So he used to read a lot. A pretty normal lifestyle. Only thing, when he was a governor of Madras, Chennai. In those days, we went to visited all the temples. He took us around. We would travel
by train,
and there were saloons. Only once we went for a tiger shoot with my father, and we had to sit so quietly. Nothing much to say about that, because when you go and sit on a machan, we were all made to sit so quietly, no whisper, nothing. Just have to sit quietly till the. But luckily, I'm not very fond of hunting and all that. And the tiger didn't turn up that day, because when they came and told him,
it was a man-eating tiger or a leopard, a rogue elephant. Mm-hmm. And this thing.
Otherwise, he didn't shoot.
He never went like that to shoot.
Yeah. See, my father had a very awe-inspiring personality. When you saw him, you thought, oh, you know, he was very awe-inspiring. We have a prayer which says, Sarve Sukhino Bhavantu. So he had that in him. So he thought everybody should do well. I can see that's why people remember him now, 100 years after he's more, you know, still people show so much love and affection. It's because of the qualities what he had in him. He had a multifaceted life. See, that's a gift he got, I think, from his, they say gift of God or your talent. When you receive such things, then you're able to do so many things. You know, in my childhood, till I got married, everything went like clockwork. So we didn't really realize what goes into making it go like that. You see, it's only after the changes that took place when things began to be different. He was a very stoic person, and I think what helped him was his philosophy, his religion. That helps you a lot to accept things, to accept change. He realized what the people liked and he wanted to go with their likes. They all took life as it came, and I would that's the most important lesson for me, I feel, to take life as it comes to you. And when I've seen them go through that, and if they can go through that, then what we go through is nothing really.
I mean, my brother moved to my father's apartment, and we moved at the back, so both of us had a different room, both his younger sister and myself. And my mother had a different room, so we all stayed together. And I think it was a difficult time for us after he passed away.
Very difficult.
Very difficult.
Both, I think, psychologically, physically, emotionally,
everything. Yeah. And financially also. Financially also.
Because they did take away all
things. Yeah, a lot of things went away, and then, you know, she had a tough time.
But did he take you into confidence, sit down with you, explain to you what's life going to be?
No, see, what's life going to be, he changed it himself, and he expected us to follow what he did. I'll tell you, the first change which took place was 1969 was the last Darbar which they had in the Darbar Hall, and he climbed the throne. So after that, in 1970, the privileges and all were taken away. And then he didn't have any grand Darbar at that time. He just, the throne was put up, he took his sword and he kept it in the Ambavilas. Then they started keeping the throne in the Ambavilas. And he took the sword and he put it on the throne and he sat next to it on a chair, which set a distinct precedence to everybody that now no longer does he enjoy those privileges of the Maharaja. And he has given whatever, because the Dasara is a very religious, ritualistic function for us. He did the rituals, put the sword on the throne, and he sat down next to it. So that itself speaks volumes. So, you know, that shows, I don't know what, it was a very emotional moment. And only he could have done that.
Here is Maharaja of Mysore, Sunil Lakam, running for the bus. You are more happier incognito rather than being known. So it is, you know, a Shakespearean tragedy.